Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. The Christianity was the first beginning of the light of the world. Christ Jesus was the first light. Christ is known as Satguru in Punjabi. And the second coming of Jesus was Nanak in the Punjab. And he was the greatest because he had the sons of Satan most high, greatest of all. In the Middle East, they had the princes of darkness, people of Judah tribe. But in the East, they have the kings and emperors of darkness, people of the Khatri tribe. So the people who are spiritually sick, God sent the prophet among them to cure them, but they loved darkness, so they killed people. So in the Middle East, if you go through the trial of Jesus, all the temple priests were hypocrites, you know, liar, and telling people, misguiding the people, that Jesus is a bad man, while the robber is a good man, to the one who robs them, because it brings money to them. So there was a hypocrisy of the first degree at the trial of Jesus. He was a good man, and Jews said, no, he's a bad man. And that came out of their heart. That is mean what is inside, same should be outside. If it's not the same, then you are a hypocrite. Politicians, they are hypocrite of the first degree, because what they preach or what they say during the elections, they all pack of lies, sugar-coated sermons are delivered to the public, and they suffer. So this trial of Jesus displays the degree of hypocrisy. How a just man was killed, beaten, put a crown of thorns, and all that, you know. And there was no limit to the hypocrisy. In India, the Khatri tribes, people, are number one hypocrite. And they also did the same as Jews did it to Christ Jesus. But they did it much harder. They put the second anointed Christ on hot iron plate in the summertime, the peak of the summertime, June, the month of June, when the temperature soared high, maybe reaching 45 degrees centigrade, then pouring hot sand on top of him. And that all was done hypocritically. Now what you see in the Middle East is all written in the Bible. Jesus said, when the end of the world come, I will bundle up the tear and burn them. So the Jews are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. They are tears because they are not faithful to Abraham. Abraham was not a Jew. He was of Semitic race. When the Jews become the Jew outwardly of the physical body, not of the heart, then they break their covenant with Abraham. They become unfaithful to Abraham. What we call the tares, sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. So, hypocrisy as it was at the trial of Jesus, and hypocrisy today is far, far greater. Under this hypocritical, that in Syria, the Assad's forces, they are killing children in the name of children and all that, you know. They are here, chemical weapons, this and that. They are trying to destroy the country, as they did Iraq, that he had a weapons of mass destruction. Nothing was found. But still, they destroyed the country. And now they have destroyed Libya. Lebanon is already destroyed. Look at what's happening in their homes now. They used to live peacefully, and now they have no peace. They have created hell among them. The safety of the people is no more there. And let's see, if they have done a good job to these countries, then they would welcome American, British, German, French, all those Italian, all those who worked there, they would welcome them into their country with open heart. But are they welcoming them? They will kill them. That means they did not do a good job. Not in the name of our Father. They worked in the name of Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. Recently, this riots in Egypt was caused by this Muslim Brotherhood, which is sectarian riots, by Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, again, the son of the Most High Satan, President Morsi. And in Afghanistan, they have sent the forces to destroy Al-Qaeda and this and that, you know, to suppress it. And here, President Obama said, no, no, give them freedom so that they can cause havoc in that country and make it equal to Iraq, Libya, and Syria, as they are done now. So their hearts are not clean. These politicians, they are hypocrites. They can see what they have done. The result is in front of them. Nobody likes them in those countries because they haven't done a good job, a bad one. But hypocritically, you know, they tell their countries, oh, we have done a good job fighting against Al-Qaeda, this and that. So what's wrong with Al-Qaeda? If they are working in their own country and they sorting the thing for the people, let them do it. Not to kill them, you know. What are you doing over there? Are you doing any good work? If it were good work, people would welcome you with open heart. Are you being welcomed in those countries? No way. So please, expose hypocrisy. That is our duty. Christ Jesus came, he exposed hypocrisy. He called the temple priest hypocrites. He destroyed their traders in their trading, turned their tables and all that, you know. While sitting at the treasury one day, he told the Jews that your fathers are devils. Because they were devils, because they are unfaithful to Abraham. If they were faithful to Abraham, Abraham would love to see Jesus, as the Samaritan woman did. She loved to see Jesus. But these Jews, They being not faithful to Abraham, they wanted to kill him, and they killed him. Same angel Stephen. He went to the temple. He was praising Abraham. Look, our forefather Abraham. He was a nice man, noble man, giving all the qualities. But they want to be Jew outwardly. They don't want to know Abraham. That is why John the Baptist said, don't you say that you have son, that you are Abraham as your forefather? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham. Stones mean thick-headed people, Jew clever people. Don't you say that. So, unless you are twice born, you won't understand gospel, and nor will understand the hypocrisy of these politicians who are ruining countries one after the other. Well, imagine what will happen when there is economic chaos in the country. People will be fighting with each other, killing each other, making it a hell. Wherever there is less disparity between rich and poor, it is shorter, as in Russia. There the people will live in peace. Wherever the gap increases, there you will see how the poor people will kill the rich people for money. Money is a noose around their neck. So anytime it can go around them. But they don't know that it's a noose. They think God is far away. Let's do whatever we want to do. So expose hypocrites. These governments are hypocrites. And openly declare your views, so that we can combat the sons of the Most High, Satan. Our Father God, bless you.